welcome back. Sorry I've been missing for a few weeks. I'm so glad I was able to film 3 videos back to back so I can spread them out a little, and I've only been missing like 2 weeks. Not that anyone's telling me I'm missing, but I feel like I'm missing, and it's important to me to be providing videos for all of you guys, especially as I see my number increasing. I see all of you 173 subbies, subscribers. I appreciate you. It means everything to me. Let me know what you guys want to see. I have 3 videos. I have like a whole list of videos I want to film. But right now, off the top of my head, I want to film 3 new videos on lip products. And I'm wearing nothing. I'm completely barefaced, as you can see. Today, we're going to talk about my skin, how horrible it's doing, and these lovely vitiligo spots. The last time I made a spots talk tutorial was a while back, and I actually added some music to it. And I don't know how all these YouTubers add music, like that's in right now, and they don't get copyrighted or whatever it is, but I totally did, and that video is mute and it's useless. So it's not going to be like that. This video is going to be on my vitiligo spots, new spots update talk. Because unfortunately, I have gotten some new vitiligo spots. Probably, I don't even know when I started noticing them. Like over the summer. I know it has to do with the sun. I don't really go out in the sun. If you want to know a little bit more about my newest spots, then keep watching. Jeez. I have new vitiligo spots. I started noticing them about maybe June, July. I was actually in Miami at my best friend's apartment doing my makeup, and I was looking at my chin and I was like, oh my God, is that a new spot? Whatever. It wasn't anything significant or nothing. But as time has passed by, the summer keeps dragging in Florida. It's extremely hot, extremely sunny for super, super long, like literally all day. If it's not raining, which is practically every day, it's sunny. And after a huge rainstorm, usually it's super hot, or it's super hot right before a huge rainstorm. Whatever. But yeah, it's just really hard to avoid the sun here where I live in Florida. And it hits my face. I try to stay out of it. I've not gone to the beach at all this summer. I've not gone to the pool. I've just literally walked to my car, walked inside my house, walked into the mall, into my job, out of all these places, and the sun just gets me. And I guess in those times, and also I have 2 dogs that need to go out like all the time because they use the bathroom outside, obviously. And I think from those little trips, like in the morning when I wake up, or in the afternoon when I was home, during the week when I was at my old job, I would have time off. Well, whatever, I would have days off during the week. So throughout the day, I would take them out, and it's super hot, and I would have no makeup on. Because when I'm home, like I'm home right now doing nothing, I do not wear makeup. The only time I wear makeup is when I leave my house. I know I shouldn't, and I know I don't have to, but I know how to cover my spots, so I will continue to cover my spots when I can. And if anyone ever wants to talk to me about vitiligo or anything, feel free to. You know I have it. I don't hide it. I actually was just FaceTiming with my friend without makeup on, and it's still so brand new to me. I felt so uncomfortable. I'm like, Nick, I don't know how I feel about this. When I do go outside to take out my dogs, it's really hot, and I'm thinking it's from that. I took them a shower or whatever. I bathed them like last month, and again, I had no makeup on, and I was not going to put on makeup. I should have put on sunscreen. I didn't. I'm really bad when it comes to sunscreen because I'm so used to not wearing sunscreen, because I don't go to the pool. I don't go to the beach. I don't go tanning. I don't do none of these Floridian things. So I don't feel like I need to wear sunscreen, even though I should, because I should, you know, watch my skin and all. But I just don't really expose myself to the sun. So I'm thinking it's from just these random hot days. I get caught up in the sun for a little longer than necessary. I don't even go to the theme parks or anything in the summer because I try to avoid the sun at all costs. The sun just makes me, just makes all this vitiligo come out more. So that's why I avoid the sun. And that is where I think these new spots have came from. Just those little things. When I wasn't wearing makeup or had my face protected or whatever. I do use makeup that has SPF in it. But I don't really apply like a sunscreen. I have really oily skin. So when I use something for my face that has SPF in it before my moisturizer or after my moisturizer, whatever, it just makes me extra oily, and I try to control my oils. And since I do try to stay indoors, or I have a job that has AC and it's in the office, like, I don't need to be protected from the sun because I'm indoors, I tend to just not gear towards putting SPF on my face. But I guess I just thought about it, and I should definitely put SPF on those little like occasions. When I'm about to take my dog, if I'm just home, it's easy, I can just put on some sunscreen. So note to self, if you don't have makeup on and you're gonna go outside, if you have vitiligo, put on some SPF. Yeah, lesson learned. We just learned something together because I just figured it out. Okay, what else? Oh yeah, let me show you my spots. Okay, so we're gonna get up close and personal. All right, so this is what I was talking about on Instagram. I haven't posted any videos lately because my skin just has been really, really, really bad. You don't know, I never got like acne all over my face, but I did get fortunate enough to break out in cystic acne. I just have extremely oily skin, and I still get cystic acne to this day around my period, when my face just feels like it. I do still suffer from cystic acne. It's just not all over, and I don't usually get it on my nose anymore, but I have extremely bad scarring on my nose. I have scars all over my damn nose. That's why I hate my nose. And in the future, I do think about getting like laser surgery or something to smooth out the surface of my nose, the skin, whatever, because I really, really do not like my nose. Not confident about my nose. I really do not like it. And lately I've been breaking out my nose, which I really don't, and it just really has been bugging me. And I don't know, hopefully, I'm sure you can see it because this video is, or this camera is just, you know, too high tech, and you can see all my flaws. Anyways, so yeah, I've just been breaking out all over. I've been starting to work out pretty much every day. I work out maybe 4 to 5 times a week now. I've lost 13 pounds. I don't sweat from my armpits. My back will sweat a little. But I am just a face sweater. Like, I sweat from my head and it just drips all over my face. Literally just like I'm water, like I put a hose on my head and I just let it fall everywhere. That's just how I sweat since I've been a kid. Like, I can look at pictures. My parents like took a picture of me like literally drenched in sweat as a kid, and it was all on my face. That's just how I sweat, and that's just what it is. So because I've been sweating so much when I work out, and progressively increasing my workouts and all that, my face has just been, I guess the sweat has just been irritating my face. So I know people say when you eat healthier and all that, it can increase your chances of your pigmentation coming back. There's certain food you can eat and all that. But I haven't noticed any changes on my skin or on my vitiligo actually from eating differently at all. I'm taking vitamins, I'm doing all this stuff, and this is just here to stay. I've always had this spot. This spot, which actually, I don't know if it looks whiter. Maybe, I don't know, it could just be me. And I've had this one. Since my last update, I have new spots here. Like, it all goes right here and here. So those are my new spots on my chin. These are newer, I never had these before. But they're not really hard to conceal because when they're newer, they're not as pigmented and they're just easy. Even foundation will just, well, actually foundation's not enough, so I now have to put on the Estee Lauder on top of these. But I definitely have new spots here. Let me just try to focus you. Can you focus? Yeah, right here. Do you see them? And then I have this one right here, which I've had. And then I have this one right here. So yeah, that's it. I don't see anything else on my face anywhere else. That's new, but these are just my new spots. So yeah, these are not that hard to conceal because they're just little circles and I just literally dab makeup over it. And they're fine to hide, but those are my new spots. I'm going to be honest, and it did bug me when I saw that I had new growth of vitiligo because I just have my face so under control, and I don't know. I still battle with this whole vitiligo thing, and like I said, I was just FaceTiming with my friend in California, and I even told him, I'm like, I still am a little uncomfortable FaceTiming you without makeup on because I've known him for so long, and to like literally just, he's like, oh, FaceTiming so we can catch up, whatever. And we did, and then I just kind of got uncomfortable as soon as the camera got on me because I'm like, oh my god, I have no makeup. You know what I mean? Like, I'm still battling with it. I'm still trying to be very positive, which I am. But, you know, it's baby steps. This whole process is baby steps. And I've improved a lot. My next thing is to... My parents don't actually know I make YouTube videos. That's why I have a hard time as well making YouTube videos. Because I wait till they're gone. Like, right now it's Saturday. I work 9 to 5, Monday through Friday. So when I get home, they're home. You know? So it's really hard to just pick up and start recording because they don't know I have this channel, and they don't know that all of my friends on social media and Facebook and all that know that I have vitiligo. So they think I just continue to hide that I have vitiligo with my makeup, and they want to protect me and not have anyone make fun of me, just look out for their daughter, whatever, which is fine. But at the end of the day, as I've gotten older, I've realized that I was just kind of hindering myself. A lot of people say I hinder myself. I do. And I agree. I have. I still do. It's something I struggle with. Just, I don't know. My confidence has completely gone down over the years, and I'm working on building it back up. And, yeah, so my parents don't know, and it just makes it really difficult recording purposes because I do live back at home right now. It's temporary. I don't know when I'm going to move out. I don't have any intentions to move out till probably next year when I'm done helping my friend out with her wedding. She's getting married, and I just rather not move right now because I want to be part of everything and just not make it complicated for either of us. So yeah, it's just really difficult filming, and I want to be more consistent. When I see I have new subscribers, it really motivates me to film more, because you know, the last thing you want to do is subscribe to someone that's really boring and doesn't put up videos. That's how you lose interest quickly. I know I do. So I can only imagine. So yeah, it's difficult recording. So any chance that they're not home, I record, which is what I'm doing right now. My next thing, to sit down with my parents, let them know, and as well as my family, because my family that lives here really close to me in Florida, they know I have vitiligo. They just don't know what it looks like because they always see me with makeup on. But that's just, you know, I should never want to hide this from my family because they're my family, and family loves each other no matter what. And especially now, I have this increasingly boost of confidence because of my friends. Like, so many people know that I have vitiligo, and it's so weird because no one questions me, no one's asking me, no one's looking at me different. No, it's like, okay, keep, like, life goes on. And I just kind of was afraid that's, I don't know what I was afraid of, but it just feels really good to just be treated the same way. I'm still Tracy, I'm still the same me. You just know a little more personal side of myself. So, I mean, I'm sure my family was going to be like, we don't care, but I just want to let them know, because I don't think my parents know how much more secure I am about myself and about my vitiligo.